What's up, Fish Gang? Welcome back to Monster Fish Only, aka Mofo Fish, where we talk about monster fish and monster tanks. I'm your host, OGP, and today we're going to be talking about the goldfish. The goldfish? Yes, the goldfish. There's actually a really dark side to this creature that nobody told you about, but don't worry about all that, because I am. DJ, run the intro.
Hey, fish gang, you know we come alive from the fish tank. Don't be getting mad cause you're fish lame. Yeah, every time you hit I do a water change. Fish gang, you know we come alive from the fish tank. Don't be getting mad cause you're fish lame. Yeah, every time you hit I do a water change. Woo!
Scooter chain, scooter chain, scooter chain, water chain, water chain. Water chain, water chain, water chain. Water chain, water chain, water chain. Water change, water change. Water chain, water chain, water chain. Water chain, water chain, water chain. Water chain, water chain, water chain.
I really got a jag and a red tail. Fish gang smooth like Denzel. Your boyfriend soft like
Ace. Alright, fish fools. Let's dive in. Today we're talking about the goldfish, and more specifically, the dark side of the goldfish that they never told you about. Number one, these fish get huge. I have been keeping monster fish for about 9 years now, and I used to just keep goldfish just to kind of, you know, keep a couple for some feeders, and just in time, in a very small amount of time, I realized that these fish get really huge. I put some in with one of my Oscars, and before I knew it, they were bigger than the Oscars. Like, these fish just grow fast, and they grow very large. They weren't quite large enough for the Oscars to pick on, and they just got really big. Unfortunately, I didn't really know much about what I was doing, and the Oscars did beat them up a little bit, and, you know, they ended up dying. Number two, they are waste machines. These fish do not have stomachs, therefore they are constantly pooping. A long intestine from front to back quickly absorbs nutrients and quickly pushes everything else out. So they don't have stomachs to keep the, you know, the food sitting there for a while and taking the time to digest and go through the process. Pretty much comes in their mouth and goes right out the other end. Number three, they are very susceptible to fungus and bacteria. Because these fish are grazers and constantly eating, they eat some things they probably aren't the best for them. Therefore, they tend to get sick more frequently because they're eating garbage all day. That's why water changes and gravel vacuuming are paramount. And honestly, it's a lot of work. Number four, they are pigs. So going along with that same content, they eat a lot and they eat it fast. So keeping them with other fish means putting a lot of food in the tank. Your other fish are going to be in constant competition with these guys because as soon as they sense it or they smell that, you know, food in the water, they're going to go crazy and they're going to eat it all up. Whatever hits the ground, whatever, or the substrate, whatever is up at the top floating around, they're going to come scoop it up. They will find it and they will eat it, and they'll eat it fast. Number five, the one that surprised me the most, they eat fish. They're omnivores. I added in some fancy guppies, which were super expensive, by the way. I think it was like $70 for like 10. And within 2 to 5 minutes, they were all gone, thanks to these guys. I was in shock and disbelief. I just genuinely could not believe my eyes. I saw these nice little, you know, what I thought were sweet little goldfish just, you know, bouncing around the tank. I threw some guppies in there and I was like, oh yeah, that's cool. And then next thing you know, it was just like, bloop, scooped them up. And I'm like, is this normal? And then saw the other ones do it. And I was like, okay, I just learned something about fish right now. And they ate them all. They ate them all. Wasted $70. Big freaking waste of money. Number six, goldfish can live 40 plus years. Talk about commitment. So, you know, obviously 40 years is, you know, 40 plus years is probably going to be, you know, the largest version of that. So, you know, it is what it is. Take that into consideration. You could be the lucky one that gets one of the ones that live 40 plus years, But at the same time, you know, there's an average median somewhere in there that's probably closer to around 20 years. So take that in consideration. You know, you're taking on one of God's creatures, and it's going to, you know, live a long life. It's going to live probably longer than your cat would live. So make sure you find a good, nice, permanent home for it, a nice, large tank for it, and provide for it, because it's going to be part of your family. Number 7. They are very expensive for many reasons. So to enjoy this fish to its maximum potential, you need a large tank, large filters, and a lot of food, and a lot of PemaFix, because goldfish in general are very hardy, but they do get fungus quite a bit. So pretty much, you know, you're gonna have to keep spending money on treating this fish for the life of the fish. I mean, it's like taking on, you know, a child. They're gonna need food, they're gonna need a place to grow, they're gonna need, you know, things to do. You're gonna have to take care of it if it gets sick. I mean, and make sure that you nurture it and raise it up into, you know, a mature adult. Obviously, it's not gonna be the same thing, because the kid's gonna run off and eventually take care of itself. But for a goldfish, you're gonna have to take care of it for its whole life. It is what it is. So just keep that in mind when you are walking into your pet store and you're like, oh, it's 28 cents. And you slap it into a little 10-gallon tank. And you think that you are doing it some type of justice. And you're honestly, you're not. So do you still want one? Well, okay, fish fool. Then I've included a care guide sheet and 50-plus fun facts via links in the description below. So before you check those out, though, do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Every time you smash the like button, your fish live a little bit longer. I'm out the tank. Thanks for watching. All right, guys, and just a quick side note. I did notice that this guy here was developing some fungus while I was filming. So I did go ahead and treat the tank. I did use aquarium salt, PemaFix, and LifeGuard. And as you can see, that was like about 3 hours ago when I first started filming at about 6 a.m. But as you can see here, it is starting to look better just within a couple of hours. So not all completely gone, obviously, but it is starting to look better. So the treatment is going well. And just to give you a quick look at stuff, that is, yep, the aquarium salt, the PemaFix, and LifeGuard. Just follow the instructions on the box and on the sides of all these products, and your fish will do just fine. Hey, you. Yeah, fish fool. If you subscribed to the channel already, then welcome to the fish game. But if you haven't, shame on you. Keep in mind, every time you subscribe to a channel, particularly maybe this one, your fish live a little bit longer. It's science. It's real science. But in all seriousness, you get a chance to win some free stuff. So hit the subscribe button, enter for your chance to win. All you have to do is just subscribe. It's going to be a Sun canister filter, the 304B, rated for like 525 gallons per hour. I want to give you guys something that I don't personally use, or I haven't personally tested. So I do have it on 3 of my tanks. I've got it on this 75 here, and I've got it on 2 125s. So we will be giving it to one of our lucky viewers for absolutely free. All you have to do is just hit the subscribe button, comment you love mofo fish, and hit that like button. We're out the tank.